Hey, quick note before we get started. Free worldwide shipping on all products in the general store at the Daydream Sound. Free worldwide shipping. If you were thinking, now is the time to go shopping at the Daydream Sound general store. Don't say I didn't tell you in advance. The shipping's on me. Now let's get on to the video. All right. Okay. We are here with the ASR-10. And today we are going to look at patch B11 of the Carpenters Sawdust Floppy Disk. That is a collection of 32 handmade, organically made from found sounds, wave samples that can be mixed, layered, matched, modulated, a whole lot of things when combined. So we're going to go through the individual patches as we have been doing, and we're now at 11 of 32. Now, patch B11 is described as a monophonic gliding fifth interval bass patch. And there's a lot of stuff going on with the actual nuances of the patch. So if you, well, let's just go through how it behaves in real time. So we'll take a listen to it here. Right, as you can hear, it's at a fifth. Now, if you tap the key, it goes through its envelope cycle. If you tap and hold the key, it momentarily mutes, continues on its cycle, but the filter clamps down on it. And then when you release, the filter, well, the envelope path continues audibly. So press full envelope pattern, press hold, still going. And as you release, you get to hear it again. So you get two types of playing styles where you can, right? You can mute it down, or you can have that full duration of it. Also, on the mod wheel, it slightly brightens it up. So you can see my hand here. That's the mod wheel. As I open it up, there's a slight brightening, very, very slight. And this is just slight nuance that you could play around with when you're actually, you know, doing your thing. So let's just take a listen to it. Just played normally. Right, very nice. Or you could clamp down. And I love the fact that it rises back up. No matter what, it always just seems to fit in nicely with what you're doing. Now, to continue on, reverb time. Let me just get reverb. Let's just listen to it inside of a space. Wicked rise. And as per usual, let us just initiate a sequence. Amazing, amazing, versatile sound. Also, there's more. I encourage you with these sounds to poke around. And by poking around, I mean just explore what the patch selects might do for you. You never know. Now, since this is operating on a fifth, that should let you know that there's two of these waveforms playing at the same time. One thing to note about this entire series are these are single, for the most part, single cycle waveforms, or very small waveforms. They may not be exactly a cycle. They're just based on the character I like, but These are not consolidated sounds. So when you hear a fifth, it means that there's more than one oscillator playing at the same time. So that means a fifth indicates that there's more than one interval going on. And in this case, there's actually more than two intervals. Let's check it out. I'm just going to touch the patch buttons and you'll see what we get to listen to. That's the complete sound. That's the top. Well, that's the bottom. That's all. So even in playing, you can choose where you want to be by isolating the oscillators. Right, a whole lot of stuff going on, and never forget that you have a whole bunch of playing styles within it. And that's what I wanted to build into all of these waveforms, the fact that there's more than just the raw waveform. It will always be moving. It will always be interacting with the way you will play, right? Even with the mod wheel as well. So there's a lot of stuff to do. And that is just a raw waveform. Of course, you're working with an amazing host sampler. And by host, I'm speaking about the EPS Classic, the EPS 16 Plus, and of course, this right here, the ASR-10, also the TS-10. If you have any of these samplers, the Carpenters Sawdust Waveform Floppy Diskette is for you. But the reason why there's so much power here is because we're working with a powerful host. This is an amazing, amazing synthesizer. Classifies it as a sampler only because it uses whatever you put in there as its oscillators, but the synthesis capabilities of this particular line of samplers is absolutely insane. Take advantage of it. I got you started here. But when you start digging in and bending things up and layering this sound with the rest of the sounds on the Carpenter Sawdust, you get a whole lot of moving textures for your music to add to what you're doing, right? So that is sound B11 of the Carpenter Sawdust. You can download the free manual right now at the Daydream Sound website to see if this diskette is for you, if that's the sort of thing you want to get into. Also, if you have any of these samplers and you have not yet gotten the Carpenter Sawdust, what on earth are you waiting for? That is all I wanted to share with you today. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.